Okay, so I'm going to try and clarify some basic things with dividend and trying to figure out, which one is the best one to purchase. There's two different ways to look at it. Okay, so remember I did a video, I don't know, maybe a week and a half ago, I was talking about the expiry dates. Now, obviously, the expiry date is important, and I made like that. Here it is here, like an expiry one where you literally write in the next expiry that you know, or the last expiry that you know, and then it does the math, figures out when the next expiry is. And once you figure out when the next expiry is, then determining when you're going to buy from it and when you're going to sell from it. So I already made all of that. So that's nothing to do with this video, though. This one I want to talk, and I will show. And after all of that data is gained out of it, then I think I made this page for it. Then I just made like the top 12, and how many shares I'm holding, and how much money is in the process of being earned from that dividend from those shares. And so you have like some kind of a scale of knowing how much you're going to earn and if you're going to sell that stock. Are you going to be selling that stock for more than this amount? Then it's okay. If you're going to be selling the stock for less, then it's not okay. So that's the difference. So it's making something like this. And then making like the buy and sell that you're comfortable with before the expiry. So like say right now, let's say I have this one and I have 40 shares of that one apparently. And I only have to make $22 on that stock. And if I cannot make $22, then it's better to keep it. Okay. So that's all. So you make some kind of a gauge like that. But that was the first section of this, and it is a very complicated to make that gauge. It is very complicated. I must say it's not the easiest formula, but it is there. If you want to look at it, and you do have to. And when I say max here, that's just a regular max. And then from there, you simply haul it out into that other sheet to go which one is the number one. Which one is, if it's a number one, then go ahead and bring back that expiry. Actually, no, I think I was just bringing back the stock name, and then I was saying go ahead and then bring back the price. That I was gaining from it. Okay. So anyway, that's enough of that. And then all those weird parameters, like, yeah, it's a pretty good way to go with it. The parameter one above. What did I have here? How many days you're comfortable buying it before expiry? How many days you plan definitely on selling it. So this is all lining it up, and then the number of buying days that you say limit. No, I'm never going to buy 10 days before or something, and before expiry. So yeah, setting up some kind of limiters on it. Anyway, so back to the actual complicated, weird, strange that they always seem to be saying, and you're like, it doesn't make any sense to me. So here we have the regular dividend. And even I get confused by this like all the time, and because I have a disordered brain anyway. Okay, so here we have the regular dividend, and it's going to say, well, over a year you get one, like this particular dividend you get 178. Actually, no, let's not use that one, use this one. You get two the dividend yield, this is the percentage. That's right. This is the percentage. So keep that in mind. So this is a 2.8%. I should have wrote that. That clarifies it. Yes, it's 2.88%. And so per share for this one at 2.8, you're going to get $11 if you hold it for 1 year, that share. Now, you're not going to hold that share for 1 year. Let's say you're only going to hold it for one quarter or a little or less than a quarter. So then you're only going to get like 2.75. Okay, so this is really the percentage, and then this is the actual dollar value. I should put those into dollar values. I never do that. Okay. So there. So here's your $2.75. So here's the quote, though. The quote is quite high. So that like I've been saying before, so you have a really high quote that makes sense that you would be getting paid 11 back from it off of 2.88%. So let's go back to over here. Now this is me just doing the same exact formula as this, but using the last year's known percentage data, because this is really like a last year follower, that 2.88%. So there's two ways to get at that same data, but this one is fine also. That's using the AI, that's using the percentage version. Okay, so now let's say, I'm looking at the problem of, let's say I have $1,000 I'm going to spend today on a dividend. So you need to know with that, because I made this here, there's $1,000. You need to know how many shares you're going to purchase, first of all, and then how many you're going to get back from that $1,000 in one quarter. Or, you know, up to expiry. So let's go back down to this one. Okay, so let's say, because it's a 386 stock quote, you're only going to be able to buy 2.59, and probably not doing fractional either, so you'll probably only end up buying two of those. So in the long run, though, it will pay you the $7 if you buy them before your expiry, and then hold through. So that will be your amount that you're looking at to, if you were going to sell before expiry, that would be your amount to beat. And if you don't beat it, if the price drops dramatically and you're like, oh no, I'm going to have to hold it for two or three more months, then you still collect your $7 versus maybe the price goes up dramatically and you're like, hey, I'm gaining $20 or $30, then you would go ahead and sell it during that quarter. And then you would have made $10 or $13 on top of had you just held it. Okay. So there's that simple mathematics. Now, to do that simple math, I'll take for this one, you take the AP, which is this is the buying number amount, and then you divide that by the actual quote. Okay, so that tells you how many shares. This would be your share number, and then over here it tells you, that tells you the share number, and then over here is the next part of the math to determine your actual dividend that it's going to earn. And so then you would take the number of shares, which is this AP number, and then you would divide that. Oh, wait a minute. Where am I at this? Yeah, that you take the AP number and then you times it by the... Now, this case, I times it by the quarterly amount. The known quarterly amount is right around in here at this 2.75. So you need to determine that quarterly amount. And then that, there you go, you get your $7 out of it. And so anyway, out of all of this, so what did I do today? Now, you know, you can make decisions and go, yay, you know, great, I'm seeing this. This one's going to give me almost $14 if I buy it right now. And you can leap out and do that, but you can always leap out and watch the stock drop immediately after you purchase it, which is what I just did. So make sure you always don't get too excited and with dividends, and try to buy them at the best entry price. And I know when they're leading up into a dividend moment, it starts to get like, oh no, you know, this is going to be my last chance. You know, it's not going to have another dip. Because chances are higher that it's going to rise in price because everybody wants it. Just be careful with that. Because it definitely reversed on me just now, like $2 or something. So that one just fried me. So I hope that helped. Now, and you also have this version, which is very important to know. Just off chance, is where you say, I'm going to buy 8 shares right now. Can you tell me what I'm going to make in dividends off of those 8 shares? Is there anyone here that closely matches the 8 shares? Yeah, this one. Okay, this one is going to give you off the 1,000. You're going to get about 7 shares, and it's going to give you about $1.38 off of those 7 shares. So not very great. But if you were going to buy 8 of those shares, what is that stock? It's a very low dividend. It's about a 0.55. I think this is probably Apple. So it's probably a 0.55. So if you were to buy 8 of those, it's saying your dividend chance on those is going to be about 1.52. It's not a chance. These are real, you know, pretty ordinary. Is a 1.52 for that expiry. And of course you get paid after, you know, a couple weeks after that. So you can always do that and say, okay, I'm going to buy, right now I'm comfortable, I'm looking at, let's say I'm looking for an entry for Apple or something, and I want to buy 10 of those. And so it's saying, you only have to beat $1.90 on your trade. So if you can beat that $1.90, let's say you make $10, then you beat the dividends. So that's really where I am with that today. Okay, so yeah, this, don't look at that upper section, that belongs to something else. But yeah, it's just this section here. But this was good. This was handy, but it's also dangerous, remember. So remember don't just put in, hey, I'm 10,000 and I'm going to buy, or I'm 1,000, I'm going to buy. Make sure you get a good entry on that stock, and use the same parameters that you were using as indicators. Don't try not to leave those, because then you'll just end up almost gambling in a way if you don't continue to follow your regular routine. Then it almost becomes too risky. So that's that for today. I'm gonna conk out of this.